Stéphane Lambiel.
Tell me.
that he has found himself. He has found his own power.
All right, Koshiro told in his social media that he was extremely inspired by your performance during Fantasy on Ice.
Okay.
And he told me yesterday he was proud when he saw your performances that you are his coach.
Okay.
You're, of course, not also an inspiration for him, but for many others. But what does it mean to you?
Well, I have to say, when he came to watch the show, I was really inspired to skate well, and I was so happy that, of course, there were many people in the audience, and I'm skating for every single person in the building, but to know that he was there and to perform with him, to perform for him, was something very special. Mm-hmm. I didn't have much time to get ready, but I really wanted to skate well. And I'm glad he enjoyed and got inspired by the show. I love to, when I see them practice, I'm also very inspired, and I want to be young again, younger. And
yes.
I feel, of course, I'm their coach, and I need to guide them and give them the instructions to move on. But I also like to support them and to listen to their needs. Mm-hmm. So I'm able to react quickly when they need to have my help and my support.
So let's talk then a little bit about your two programs that you performed in Fantasy on Ice. Both are really sad and emotional. Especially this bitter earth. How did you choose them?
It feels like it's so far from what I'm living right now in the camp. It was really like a different time, a different atmosphere. But it's so far from what I'm living right now. I mean, you need to know that coaching and performing, they are so far from each other. Like when I'm coaching, I don't know that I'm here. Like, it's hard to understand, but it's almost like using two different brains. And when I perform, I don't remember that I'm a coach, kind of.
So then you're really the performer yourself.
Yeah, so it's
two worlds.
it's really like two worlds. And when I was performing in Japan, I enjoyed it so much to have this chance, this opportunity during the COVID pandemic. I never thought, or I didn't expect, because it was so difficult to plan and difficult to imagine something coming up. So I just forgot about this whole world. And then suddenly I was able to perform again. And it was such a great experience. I was so happy that I had this chance to do it again. And I used the opportunity to like full potential. And those two programs are rather sad, talking about being lost in one of them, and in the other, for this bitter earth, it's really that connection with this world that is a bit mad and crazy and sick. And nevertheless, we need to keep the hope, and we need to keep looking forward and moving on. And bad things, they happened. They happen still. And with hope, and there is a big message of continuity, in the sense that even nature is so big, it's bigger than anything, and it's beautiful, and I'm surrounded by this beauty around us, and But sometimes it takes your life away. It takes your precious things away. It still continues, and we need to to accept that, and we need to. I don't know. I felt pretty connected with that song every time the music started. I was inspired. I was happy to just be and perform.
So during that this bitter earth, there's a moment when you fall on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
I was asking myself, how do you manage to do this? It looks very dramatic and painful. Mm-hmm. And
there are a few things that are specific to that piece. You mentioned the fall. The fall is really about, in our world, we have gravity, and gravity brings us down. But this gravity, sometimes we try to, because we are afraid of going down, sometimes we don't allow ourselves to go down, but sometimes we need to go down to get up again. And this is that sensation of like collapsing. And after that collapse, you build up again. And there is like, really, it's that sensation of hope. You know, it's broken. It's hard to get up. It's hard to move on. It's hard to still believe. But that little hope grows, and life comes back. And the other point that is very special to that piece is I like improv, but I have learned to practice so hard that I felt not comfortable anymore improvising. Because when you are a perfectionist, you tend to try to go to the schedule and to the point. And then Rudia, the choreographer who I worked with for that number, she wanted to challenge me in putting improvisation in that piece. Mm-hmm. And it felt really uncomfortable for me to know that mm-hmm. I will go on the ice, not knowing exactly what I will have to do. So it was quite disturbing. But at the same time, I liked the challenge. I wanted to push myself towards that. And she gave me some techniques and some exercise to allow myself to feel confident about improvising. And we worked on having one intention, one kind of direction, and to just trust that direction, that my body will be smart enough to experience that. And that's what I basically did. When there are a few parts in that program where I improvise, and they are connected with each other, those three parts. So once I'm behind the curtain, and sometimes I was behind the curtain and I was still asking myself, what is my intention? What is my action, my thought? And I was kind of empty of thoughts. And something came up to my mind, and that was what happened. And it was quite a beautiful experience to live that.
Now it makes sense why the program changed every time.
Yes, exactly. So every time was different with a different intention. And I enjoyed that challenge very much. Yes.
You were not only an outstanding artist, but also an athlete still, and you showed that you can still manage to jump the quad. How do you practice it, and how do you manage this?
I practice it by teaching it.
Yeah.
It's when you teach, you need to kind of, your brain needs to slow down a little bit the movement and try to understand what's happening on each step of the movement and the motion. So I think it really helps me to see all the skaters and all the students do their thing. And then slowly you put things together for each skater with different focus. Some skaters, they really want to turn. Some skaters, they cannot really push. So you need to kind of fix things, and then you see so many examples, so it helps you a lot to kind of put the things together. Of course, you need to physically still be able. So I'm working on my body to keep my joints healthy and my muscles activated. But yeah, the mind work is big when you coach.
It's really impressive.
現れたのは。プロスケーターの宮原さとこさんとステファン・ランビエールさん。宮原さんは荒川さん演じる主人公の若かりし頃、恋人役のランビエールさんと出会い、幸せな時を過ごします。
シングルスケーター同士でリフトにも挑戦しました。2人の演技を見た荒川さんは、すごい素敵、何気ないちょっとした間の使い方とか表現が今すごいいいと思います。宮原さんのそのすごく繊細できめ細やかなスケートが、そこに本当にステファンの包容力、スケートの
美しさで、すごいコラボレーションなんですよ。3人のコラボレーションでステイポジティブを伝えます。ソロで見せられる限界をもっと超えてコラボレーションっていうのはお届けでき、宇野選手には支えとなっている人物が。2020年からコーチを務めるステファン・ランビエールさん。
モチベーションっていう部分に、そのステファン・ランビエールコーチがいてくれる大きな存在だと思います。
そんな2人の練習を見てみると思わず倒れ込む宇野選手。するとランビエールコーチは足をつかみ体をゆさゆさ。今度はぐるぐる回転、まるで遊んでいるかのよう。